In this video, I'm going to show you how to make an interactive photo page. In the first step, we're going to create a thumbnail and have it enlarge and center when you click on it. Let me show you what the result should be. I have a small picture of Leah. This is a dog I used to have. And when I click on her, I get a large picture. If I click on the red X in the corner, the screen redraws. The large image disappears, and you'll see the small image flicker briefly, but it redraws on top of the black background. Let's look at what we did to accomplish this. The first thing that we had to do is create a P image called Leah. In the sketch, I added the Leah JPEG file to my library for this processing project. In my setup, I set the background to black, the size to 900 by 600, and I have my variable, my P image, Leah. I load the image, Leah.jpg, into it. In the draw section of the program, I load the image using the keyword image, then Leah, X and Y, 20 and 20, and I set the size at 100 by 103. The image that I loaded is in the full size of 400 by 412. I'm just displaying it smaller here. I don't have a separate image. I don't lose image quality when I display a smaller one, but it would degrade if I made it larger. So you should set your photos to the largest size that they're going to display in your program. I'm detecting when I click the mouse. So if mouse pressed in Leah's picture, which is the size is defined here, then I translate so that my new XY coordinates start at the width divided by 2 minus 200 and the height divided by 2 minus 206. That's because the large size image is going to be 400 by 412. And I redraw it in the new coordinates, so this translation makes those new, that new sets the new zero point centering the picture on the screen. Then I draw the red X in the top corner. I set a stroke color to red, the stroke weight to 3, and then I draw two short intersecting lines to make the X. Now, when I leave this if statement, my coordinate system returns to the original 0, 0. So my detection for the X and Y doesn't align. And you can do math to figure it out, but there's an easier way to figure out where that red X is. How I solved that was to have print lines show up and give myself the mouse X, mouse Y coordinates. So you can see wherever I click, I'm getting the coordinate numbers. So I can click in the Leah picture, and wherever I'm clicking, I can get the X, Y coordinates. I can click on screen here. Now I did make this actually work so it's just a little larger than the X area, but you can see when I clicked on the 665-131, that actually triggered the X. To find it, before I made it where it would redraw the background over the center image, notice all this does is it sets the background to zero. It won't go into the if statement unless the mouse pressed happens again. So I set the background to zero if I click in the appropriate spot. When I was trying to figure out where that X and Y coordinate started, I just clicked, and I'm going to be a little outside the area here, and figured out where it was by clicking. It was easier than figuring out the math between the translation, though you can do it that way too. So basically what happens is we determine if we click on the picture, on the larger picture, if we click the red X, it will redraw the background over that location, and then when you go into draw, Leah, the small size, gets redrawn because that's not part of an if statement. So that's the first step in our interactive photo page.